All right, the Biden Justice Department dealing a major blow to female high school athletes and their fight for fairness. Last night, the DOJ withdrew support for a lawsuit that would block transgender athletes in Connecticut from participating in girls' sports. Former Attorney General Bill Barr initially backed that lawsuit, arguing that Connecticut's law violated Title IX protections. But the agency, now under new leadership, apparently disagrees. The lawsuit will continue without the DOJ's support. Joining me now, Alana Smith, one of the athletes who filed the suit, and her attorney, Christina Holcomb, of the Alliance Defending Freedom Legal Counsel. So, Alana, for those of you people watching who don't know your story, why did you file this lawsuit, and are you disappointed by the Department of Justice decision not to back it?
I got involved after I ran against the biological males at the New England meet because in the 200 meter, I took third place when I should have gotten runner up. And it's not really about placement, but it's all about knowing that I work so many hours a week to be able to get runner up at New England's as a freshman. And I am really disappointed in the news because me and the other girls, Selena and Chelsea, have worked really hard to get our stories out there, to get people to realize that fairness needs to be restored in our sport and all other women's sports.
Yeah, Christiana, you know, from a political perspective, the left claims to always want to stand up for women. They're the party of women. And yet here we are with policies that disenfranchise female athletes. And I have serious questions about what this means in terms of harassment of female athletes. Does this mean that biological males are now allowed to go into the locker room as well as compete against them and take away scholarships and placement in state championships? I know that the lawsuit is going to move forward despite DOJ pulling their support for it. So where are you going from here?
Well, the lawsuit absolutely moves forward. But as you mentioned, this was clearly a politically motivated decision to side with radical activists over female athletes like Alana. But what's even more concerning is this effort to gut legal protections for women is not just isolated to what we see in Connecticut. You know, even now, the Biden administration is pushing the so-called Equality Act, which ignores the real physical differences between men and women and threatens women's privacy, women's homeless shelters, and yes, even women's sports on a national level for female athletes like Alana.
Yeah, as you point out, it's not just about athletics, but about other aspects of protecting women from harassment and putting them into a place where they feel comfortable. But in terms of athletics, Alana, when it comes to the things that you've missed out on, you know, when people say that it's only fair to allow biological males to compete against you, what is your response to that?
That people should realize that a lot of biological females have missed out on making it to meets that really matter, like states and regionals, and the transgender athletes have taken spots on the podium that belong to biological females. We train for so many days a week, so many hours, to be able to be the best in our state and the best in our region, and these biological males are just taking it away from us, and we really deserve it.
Christiana, really quickly, I know that the ACLU is arguing that this fits into Title IX, that transgendered athletes are entitled to compete against women as women in their sport. But what about the other side of the argument that Title IX is supposed to protect people like Alana?
That's exactly right. Title IX was designed to ensure that girls like Alana have a fair and level playing field, have the chance to showcase their talents, to be champions, and frankly, to earn those college scholarships. Mm-hmm. So we want to move forward and we want to see women's sports protected across the country.
All right. Alana Smith and Christiana Holcomb, thank you so much.